stage. I think I did a pretty good job. I think like an Oscar or Emmy or something around here. But no, I really do. I appreciate the young people and their hearts and parents getting them here. You won't regret it. That's your best thing in the eternity of your child. That's awesome thing. But tonight, I'm thankful for the opportunity to preach. I want to be mindful of your time. But I appreciate the opportunity. This is the third time this month y'all have had to put up with me. But I'm thankful. I seriously am. I appreciate every opportunity I get to preach and share my heart with you guys. And tonight, it's amazing. When I was told that I was going to have to preach, I started to pray and ask God what he would have me do as far as direction. And tonight, I really want to preach with the Lord's help on a topic and an area in my life that I really want to work on and I want to improve. There's so many times, I think, in my life where I fall short in this area, and maybe you, too, can identify with me tonight. And that's the area of my prayer life. If you want to turn your Bibles with me, it'll be Luke chapter 11. It'll be in verses 1 through 4. But you know what's the truth? Some of you that have smaller kids or younger kids, you know, kids sometimes have this uncanny ability to grasp, like, even the deepest of spiritual things, like prayer. It's a beautiful thing, and I don't know if you've ever heard a child pray. It's one of the most heartfelt, genuine, sincere things you'll ever hear. And it's from the mouth of a child, and they'll pray. What I love about children when they'll pray about anything and everything. They'll pray about, you know, their mom, their dad, their sister, you know, who got in trouble. You know, Lord be with her, you know, she's grounded, you know. They'll pray about animals and dogs and puppies. And I think that blesses the heart of the Lord. They have the right idea. They have an open heart, an open mind when it comes to prayer. And I think sometimes, like I said, they have some of the most heartfelt, but they also have possibly some of the most funny prayers or stories about prayers that kids do. And I have a couple. In the spirit of the past few preachers that have been telling jokes, I want to join the club tonight. So bear with me. I've got some corny prayer stories that involve young children. So bear with me. And courtesy laugh, if necessary. If I give you a signal, laugh away. All right. First one that says, the preacher's five-year-old daughter. I know you're not 5 years old, but you are. Oh my goodness, the story is you. You didn't know this. I talked to Jalen before service and got this story. Olivia, you as well. The preacher's 5-year-old daughter noticed that her father always paused and bowed his head for a moment before starting his sermon. One day she asked him why. Well, honey, he began proud that his daughter was so observant of his messages. I'm asking the Lord to help me preach a good sermon. To which his daughter replied, how come he hasn't done it yet? Second one, it says, a preacher said to a rambunctious 6-year-old boy, so your mom makes you say your prayers, or she says your prayers for you each night. That's awesome. That's a good parent. What does she say? The little boy replied, thank God he's asleep. Thank God he's in bed. One more. My wife invited some people to dinner, and this is not a personal story, so Jennifer, don't. Yeah, this is funny. I can picture this happening. My wife invited some people to dinner. At the table, she turned to our 6-year-old daughter and said, would you like to say the blessing? This is dangerous, right? I just wouldn't know what to say, Mom. The child replied, just say what you hear your mom would say. The wife said, y'all know. Our daughter bowed her head and said, dear Lord, why on earth did I invite all these people to dinner? You gotta love the heart of a child. They are so genuine, and they will say the truth and nothing but the truth, no matter what. So it's a blessing and a curse, right? All right. But you know that. I don't know about you all tonight, but and I might be weird. I don't know how you are, but I enjoy. Walk of life they come from. It's interesting, the way people pray is almost first things in mind. Don't be as a hypocrite. No vain repetitions. Keep in mind your prayer life can be hindered if you're living a carnal life, if you don't have a good relationship with your spouse and that God's put around you. Keep this mindset. Therefore, when you pray like this. He says, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And again, saying these phrases, is it going to make you a prayer warrior? Is it going to make you, the next Daniel or a modern day Daniel? He's giving you a pattern. And the pattern that sometimes it's not that we get our priorities out of whack, but I think sometimes we kind of forget things. It's interesting. I heard a preacher one time make the point regarding prayer. He's described his house as a house of prayer. He used that word. He used that act. When he could have used a house of worship, a house of praise, a house like so many of us. Like I said, I got saved when I was 17. I grew up in a church much like this one. But when I got saved, and this is not a bash against my church, I love my church, I'm proud of where I'm from, I'm proud of my heritage. But when I got saved, they gave me a Bible that was had my name embossed on the front of it. They baptized me in the baptismal waters. I went to a Christian college, and I realized I had never been soul winning, and I was 18 years old. I didn't realize I knew how to. I didn't know how to study the Bible. I didn't know how to walk with God. And me and Jennifer were talking about it tonight. You know, the Bible talks about in several places about the older teaching the younger, the older women instructing the younger women, and likewise to the older men instructing to the younger men. Talking about it, isn't it crazy how in classes and things like that, they divide us up by age. You know, whenever I think about whenever I was a young boy, I had people like that in my life. But man, I would have killed to have a Wildwood Braswell or a Brother Wildwood Kane or Brother Randall Lamb, like one of those guys poured into my life. But by the structure of the church, we were separated. I was with people my age. And so I was in Christian college, and I was just learning how to walk with God. So I'm not saying this to insult anybody, but there might be someone here tonight, one of my teens or younger, you're like, I don't know, I didn't know how to pray. And I know how to say grace, I know how to, you know, thank God for my food or ask for something, but I didn't know that God gave us a pattern for prayer. There's nothing to be ashamed about. Like I said, I didn't learn a lot of those things until I was 18, 19 years old. Don't assume. Don't ever assume that because you go to church or you've been there for 20 years that you know even the most basic things sometimes. Because those things tend to be the most difficult, right, to do. A walk with God, pray, and read your Bible is the thing that we struggle with the most sometimes. So tonight, as Jennifer begins to play, my challenge to